Ah, greetings, good sir, or madam. Oh yes, of course you are. Pardon my lack of observation. Yes, I can see that clearly now. Please accept my humble apologies. It has to be said that, while fortunately nowadays fashion does not restrict ladies, gents, and intersex individuals in their self-expression anywhere near as much as it used to, it can, on occasion, lead to mild bouts of confusion. But be that as it may, welcome to the Olde Blade Shoppe. Byron Pursebane at your service. How may I be of assistance on this fine day? I see, a large and heavy sword. Well, this would be a rather peculiar request, if you don't mind me saying so. However, I shall strive to my utmost to satisfy your requirements. What would spring to mind immediately is this model here, which is easily our most substantial blade. While it may not look particularly long, as you will notice, it has a fairly wide leaf-shaped blade, which, together with the considerable heft, allows you to translate a lot of muscle power into, how do they call it down in Red Harbor? Oomph. Yes, indeed. If you feel it for yourself, you will notice that it has indeed remarkable weight and is not quite as refined and agile as other blades, which would be more suitable for fencing against another blade. Depending on what you are facing, if raw damage potential is what you're looking for, this would be... Oh, please don't touch the edge like that. Oh. I'm sorry. Please have a handkerchief. Yes, if you would be so kind to make sure that you don't drip on the carpet. Yes, thank you very much. Yes, I can of course see that you would want to verify the sharpness of the edge for yourself. However, I do have to admit I am somewhat flabbergasted as to what made you think it prudent to do so by rubbing your thumb along the edge rather than across it. Oh, well, it is not what you're looking for at any rate. Well, in that case, allow me to take it off your hands before another misfortune strikes. Might I inquire what sort of application you had in mind for this blade? Is that so? In other words, what you're telling me is that you will be going up against a Durobrass-plated Tyler Bradford Mark III, is that correct? I see. Well, considering that you will be dealing with such an imposing machine, may I suggest an alternative, namely this double-barreled shotgun, which I would highly recommend loading with unobtanium-jacketed pressurized aether core slugs. That will allow you not only to stay at a safe distance from such a behemoth, it would also facilitate cracking the hard shell, if you will, because the armor plating is not exactly what you would call delicate. It's, no. So, you would prefer a melee weapon to, well, in that case, I would suggest something more of this nature. This mace here, as you can see by its design, concentrates tremendous force on a very small surface, which would allow you to dent armor plating, maybe puncture it, and overall it would be a lot more effective against such heavy material. Considering that this sort of weapon was designed to be used against armor in the first place, which, as you may know, or maybe not, a sword is not really optimized to do. Its primary task is to slice, cut, chop flesh, which is rather tender compared to something like durobrass. Of course, you could try to thrust the point into any gaps between the plating, but if you ask me, this would simply be an unnecessary risk. So, could I maybe persuade you to consider something like this instead? Or going back to the more prudent alternative, if you don't mind me saying so?